Namaste, we the Sanskrit students from Sri Kanyaka Parameshwari Arts and Science College for Women are wishing you all a very, very happy Pongal. India is a land of festivals. Every festival is celebrated with enthusiasm. It also represents our culture. Among other festivals, Pongal is one of them. Beginning of January 15th is the time for Pongal celebrations. Millions of people from various regions will begin celebrating Pongal with generous enthusiasm and mouth-watering feasts. Observed across the state of Tamil Nadu for ages, this 4 days festival is celebrated with much enthusiasm all over the region. What is the term Pongal means? The term Pongal is derived from the Tamil literature, which means to boil. It is an ancient festival of South India, particularly Tamils. It is basically an harvest festival for crops like rice, sugarcane, turmeric, etc. Other names for Pongal festival are Sankranti, Makara Sankranti, Maga, Mela, Magi, Makara Pongal, and Thai Pongal. How many days does the festival held? Pongal festival is a 4-day celebration affair, each day marked by different festivities. First day is called as Bogi festival. Second day is called Thai Pongal. The third day is called as Mattu Pongal, and the last day of the Pongal festival is called Kanum Pongal. Bogi Pongal. Bogi Pongal is the first day of the 4-day Pongal festival and Makara Sankranti. It is a festival celebrated widely in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, and Telangana. How is Bogi celebrated? Bogi celebrations revolve around building the traditional bonfire, popularly known as Bogi Mantalu. For Bogi, people discard old things and concentrate on new things, causing change or transformation. That is, Palayana Kalidalum, Pudiyana Pugudalum. Pongal. Pongal is also referred to as Thai Pongal, Makara Sankranti. Makara Pongal is the multi-day harvest festival observed by the Tamil community. It is observed at the start of the Tamil month of. Why the Pongal is celebrated? Pongal is one such festival that is celebrated to thank Sun God and Lord Indra for helping farmers in getting better yielding crops.
The story behind Makara Sankranti. According to legends, it is believed that Sankranti, after whom the festival is named, was a deity who killed a demon called Shankarasur. In India, it is considered to be a date from when the sun begins to move north, as before Makar Sankranti, the sun was shining on the southern. Mattu Pongal. Mattu Pongal is the third day of the 4-day Pongal festival. It is celebrated on 16th January. In Tamil, the word Mattu means bull, and this day of Pongal is for celebration of cattle, particularly bulls that play a vital role of working hard to help the farmers to raise crops on their. What is the story of Mattu Pongal? The legend associated with Lord Shiva is that on the 3rd day of Pongal, Lord Shiva sent his bull Nandi to tell people to have an oil bath daily and eat once a month. Nandi told people to eat daily and bath once a month. After that, angry Lord Shiva sent Nandi on earth to help humans harvest more food, and that is when Pongal became a harvest festival. How was Mattu Pongal celebrated? On the Mattu Pongal day, cattle are washed, their horns painted and decorated with shiny metal caps, multicolored beads, tinkling bells, sheaves of corns and flower garlands are tied around their necks. Turmeric and kumkum are also devotionally put on the foreheads of the cat. Jallikattu. Jallikattu is typically practiced in the Indian state of Tamil Nadu as a part of Pongal celebrations on Mattu Pongal Day, which occurs annually in January. Jallikattu has been known to be practiced during the Tamil classical period between 400 to 100 BCE. It was common among the Ayyar people who lived in the Mullai. It became a platform for display of bravery and prize money was introduced for participation encouragement. The term Jallikattu comes from Tamil terms salli kasu, which means coins, and kattu, which means package tied to the horns of bulls as prize money. Jallikattu, also known as eru thaluvudal and manju virattu. Jallikattu, which is celebrated at Alanganallur near Madurai, is the most popular. Kanum Pongal. The fourth and the last day of Pongal is known as Kanum Pongal. Kanum Pongal is also known as Karinal. Sun god is worshipped on the day and people offer food along with Sarkarai Pongal. Why do we celebrate Kanum Pongal? Kanum Pongal is treated similar to the Raksha Bandhan as women offer special prayers towards the sun god for the well-being of their brothers, and as per the customs and traditions, women visits the brother places. The day is also popularly treated as the sightseeing day as well as the Thanksgiving Day. The day of Kanum Pongal is often acknowledged as the Thiruvalluvar Day in remembrance of the great historic Tamil writer. Significance: Thanksgiving for cattle, ancestors and farming livestock, visiting relatives' houses. Slokas chanted on the day to Sun God. Surya Namaskara Mantra. Surya Namaskara is performed before the sunrise. The mantras are recited to pray Lord Surya with sandals, flowers, rice grains are offered with water. There are 12 mantras which are different names of Sun God. With each posture, a particular mantra is chanted. Surya Namaskara mantras are meaning, who is friendly to all.
Om Ravaye Namaha.
Meaning, the shining one, the radiant one. The dispeller of darkness and responsible for bringing activity. Meaning, one who illumines the bright one. Is all pervading, one who moves through the sky.
Om Ushne Namaha.
Meaning, giver of nourishment and fulfillment.
Om Hiranyagarbhaya Namaha.
Meaning, who has golden color brilliance.
Om Marichaye Namaha.
Meaning, the giver of light with infinite number of rays.
Om Adityaya Namaha.
Meaning, the son of Aditi, the cosmic divine mother.
Om Savitre Namaha.
Meaning, one who is responsible for life.
Om Arkaya Namaha.
Meaning, worthy of praise and glory.
Om Bhaskaraya Namaha.
Meaning, giver of wisdom and cosmic illumination. Surya Bija Mantra. Powerful Bija Mantra of Lord Surya gives positive vibrations and grace from the Lord Sun.
Om Haram Harim Hram Sahasuryaya Namaha.
I salute the great Sun God for His divine grace. Benefits of Surya Bija Mantra. The Surya Bija Mantra has the magnificent power to create a life of abundance and fame with prosperity and austerity, and also has the healing powers to remove disease and negative impacts of any nature. Surya Gayatri Mantra. Best time to chant this most powerful Surya Mantra is during eclipse of the sun and Sunday mornings at sunrise. April 12th to 23rd is most auspicious for sun worship, so one should try to spend more time reciting the mantra during this period.
Om Bhaskaraya Vidmahe Mahadvitya Dikaraya Dhimakhe Tanno Aditya Prachodayat.
Meaning, Om, let me meditate on the Sun God. Ho, maker of the day, give me higher intellect and let Sun God illuminate my mind. Benefits of Surya Gayatri Mantra. This liberating mantra, when chanted every day with full concentration in praise of the Sun God, produces positive energy and divine blessings from the Sun God. It strengthens one's body, purifies his mind and uplifts his spirituality. The mantra can provide one with the fame and success anywhere and everywhere. Surya Mantra.
Namah Suryaya Shantaya Sarva Roga Nivarine.
Meaning, Oh Lord Surya, ruler of the universe, you are the remover of all diseases, the respiratory of peace. I bow to you and please bless your devotees with long life, health and wealth. Benefits of Surya Mantra. To bask in the divine grace of the Sun God, this mantra can be chanted. It is known to eradicate diseases from its roots and help develop the physical and mental endurance required to overcome all of life's obstacles. Aditya Hridayam Mantra. The word Hridaya means that which is especially nourishing and healing for the heart or heart of Aditya. The word Hridayam refers to the one who is shining or dwelling in the heart.
Aditya Hridaya Punyam Sarva Satru Vinasanam Jayavaham Jepanityam Aksharam Paramam Shivam.
Meaning, this mantra can be used to thank Surya Dev. Benefits of Aditya Hridaya Mantra. The brightness of the sun grants one knowledge and the power to work fast when he chants this mantra. Invoking the sun god by this mantra makes one fearless. The negative thoughts of ego, anger, greed, desire and treachery are also cleansed from his mind. Thus, We can see that chanting of the Surya Mantras helps one to begin the journey towards uncovering his inner beauty and power. Regularly chanting fulfills all aspirations of the devotees. These mantras manifest the different qualities of Surya, such as willpower, fame, general vitality, courage, kingship, and authority, etc., in one's daily life. However, certain rules need to be kept in mind during chanting to get above mentioned results to the fullest.